Welcome to Bitcoin Stuff. I define Bitcoin as what you would have now if you had bought the original Bitcoin before the splits. So if you have a Bitcoin, to me, that means that you have one unit of Bitcoin Core, which is what I call the units of the core chain of Bitcoin, and you have one unit of Bitcoin Cash, and you have units of a few other pieces. Now, the fact that many people are saying that the core chain somehow owns the rights to the word Bitcoin, that means nothing to me, because I am framing things in the way that is relevant to investors. So it is just like in natural history, where if a population splits, then we have a name for the common ancestor, and we have two new names for the two daughter species. So if you are holding a Bitcoin, what that means is you are maximizing your future decision-making capacity, okay? Because you're going to continue to have all of the options that are eventually going to show up anywhere in whatever comes out of the original Bitcoin, okay? Whereas if you pick one side or the other, then you are allying yourself with one team or the other. In other words, you are making a prediction that team will be chosen by the rest of the investors. Now, the most important question about a fork is what fraction of the total number of Bitcoins were already mined at the time the fork happened? And the reason this is important is it says how much the outcome is going to be determined by new investors versus old investors. Okay, so if few Bitcoins have been mined, then the result is mostly going to be determined by new investors. So if you pick one or the other, what you're saying is, I think that a lot of new investors are going to prefer this one in the future. Okay, but if a lot of Bitcoins have already been mined, then it's mostly old investors who determine the outcome. Every choice here is a prediction about what other investors are going to do, okay? That's the nature of the choice. I mean, that is what the stakes are, because if you don't choose on that basis, then you are going to lose, right? So the winning choice is the one that predicts what future investors are going to do. So Bitcoin is a choice that means maximizing my future decision-making capacity, and Bitcoin Core and Bitcoin Cash are choices that mean I am predicting that this team is going to attract more old Bitcoin investors. Do you see what I mean? Like if you pick one or the other, that's saying everybody else is going to join me eventually, and so I want to get in early, okay? Whereas if you don't, then you say I am out on this decision, but I will have retained my ability to make decisions in the future. So this is how you should think about Bitcoin forks. And I think it's fine if you don't want to frame things in this way. I just think it is self-defeating if you don't think this way.